This is Match Day at the Ann Burnett Marion School of Medicine at Texas Christian University. Frog Center starts right now.
I also want to say we are 100% matched, and I am so
Let's go!
Match Day 2023, the annual nationwide event where fourth-year medical students find out if they have received spots in the residency training programs of their choice, is now completed. Match Day typically happens on the third Friday of March every year. I'm Stuart Flynn, the founding dean of the Burnett School of Medicine at TCU.
And I'm Joanna Luke, the Associate Dean of Curriculum at the Burnett School of Medicine at TCU. Welcome to Frog Center and an exciting recap of our school's first match day. Our inaugural class of medical students, known as the Dorman Scholars, participated in the celebration that we had today. The class is named after Fort Worth businessman H. Paul Dorman, one of the founding donors of our medical school. His generous gift covered the first year of tuition for the class of 2023 when they began medical school in July of 2019.
Now that we've got up to speed, let's get to the action at TCU's Amon G. Carter Stadium, home of the Fiesta Bowl champion Horned Frog football team. Medical students and their loved ones made their way into the stadium at 10 in the morning, waiting in anticipation for the 11 o'clock bell when medical students all over the U.S. find out at the same time where they've matched.
Now our match day has a special twist. We added a little Fiesta Bowl and TCU Horned Frog magic. A VIP guest threw each medical student a custom-made football with the student's name, and then they could remove the sticker on the ball to reveal where they had matched.
3, 2, 1.
After months of interviewing at programs across the country, it's truly wonderful to see the reactions of the students and their loved ones as they found out where they've matched. Our digital media producer and marketer, Juan Cabrera, is where it all took place.
Thank you, Dean Flynn. You can feel the emotion from the students and families here today. This is the culmination of the students' hard work over the 4 years here at the Burnett School of Medicine.
I'm just so excited, and I just love the environment that they created. I mean, they are phenomenal folks, full of just the most amazing opportunities for innovation and research, but it's also a very just supportive environment, and I felt like that I would have the support that I would need to thrive here.
I'm excited to start my residency training because, I mean, it's been a long journey to get here. I think I've found my passion in life, which is internal medicine, and I love working with patients in underserved populations, and I want to have that power as a full attending in the future to finally be able to do that. And the only way to do that is through residency.
So, a couple comments on your match day event as it compared to today's.
So I can tell you for sure we did not have footballs.
Okay.
And we also received the results actually on paper at our mailbox. And so there was a yellow ribbon, and at 11 o'clock they cut the ribbon and everyone ran to their mailbox and pulled it out and read it. So that we didn't get announced, no footballs, but it still was such a memorable day.
So can you just frame for folks who have not gone through a match day, both the range of emotions a student has leading up to 11 o'clock,
So it really is hard to put into words what that week is like waiting for that Friday morning when you find out not only where you're going, but to know for sure which specialty you're going to be practicing. And so these are students that have poured their blood, sweat, and tears into this career, and it all comes down to that 1 minute when you either open the envelope or catch a football and find out if the specialty you want to be into has chosen you and then where you're going to go live for the next 3 to 7 years or beyond.
Once the medical students find out their doctor destiny, the next step is figuring out where they're going to live in the new city they'll be working in for the next few years.
That's right, Dean Flynn. Residency positions start in June or July, and match day happens in March, so it's a really fast turnaround. Our web manager, Nicole Wright, was at the event today as well.
Thanks, Dr. Luke. Now that the students know where they have matched, they can turn their attention to the next chapter of their medical journey.
I'm really excited to meet all my new co-residents. I've had a really good time here with all my classmates, and they've really become like family to me, and it's almost getting me emotional, like seeing all the things that they're going to do, and I'm really excited to meet a new group of people.
The new family I get to join at my new place, like the new residents, and all the relationships I'll get to build long-term, and also just seeing, being able to help so many people, because I've been to school for so long, and now I get to say I'm a doctor and I can help you. I'm looking forward to that, and just learning so much, continuing to learn and to be the best doctor I can be.
So you've also been a program director. So you're also on the end of accepting new residents. So how do you begin then helping them acclimate into their new city, your institution, and your residency program?
So we are so lucky that our students matched into great programs across the country. And in those programs, it is really standard to really hit the ground running, getting those students ready to go, knowing they just have a few months before they move or start that program. And so as a program director, I actually called all of my new interns that day, match day, and told them, you know, enjoy celebrating this weekend, but Monday morning we're going to be getting started. Start looking for emails where we tell you your schedule for the next year, where we tell you where to come for orientation, all of the different license and certificates and things that you'll need to get started.
So can you comment on our graduates that are staying in Texas, some of the local programs?
So we were so excited to see quite a few of our students staying in the Metroplex. So for example, they got selected at programs such as Family Practice at JPS, which is a top program in the nation. They're going to Baylor All Saints, which is a great partner of ours, to Dallas Methodist, a great partner of ours. They're going over to Dallas, to Bumsey, to Southwestern. So staying in our Metroplex, which is really going to help our local workforce. Additionally, we've got students that matched all over Texas. So we're sending students to Austin, to Temple, to Houston. And again, the hope would be that we could draw them back after they finish residency here to Fort Worth. And it's a lot more likely when they stay in Texas.
We are now set to graduate our first class of medical students who have become empathetic scholars, a term we've coined at the Burnett School of Medicine at TCU. We have trained them to be compassionate, empathetic, and prepared to discover the latest medical knowledge in medical care with the tools to ask and answer medical questions of the future.
These students will have the ability to walk in a patient's shoes while being physicians that will excel in the science of medicine as they move into residency. That is something the students said that they value the most during their time here.
Let's go!
So the curriculum's individualized, and that was huge for this. So for the last 6 months, I was able to, in addition to being good at medicine, because I'd been in clinic for 3 years, where the normal curriculum year at two, I had the opportunity to spend 5 months in interventional radiology. UCLA, I did my rotation, it was my last month, so by the time I walked in there, I'd done 4 months of interventional radiology, and I'd been mentored by preceptors for three straight years when it came to medicine. So by the time I went in there, I felt comfortable talking to the attendings, working with the residents, and then also putting in my work with everybody, and staying first in, last out, and so all that together, I felt like really helped me thrive.
If I had to point it down to one thing, I would really say the compassionate practice. I feel like that really helped me shine, both in my patient encounters and the way I talk to different folks in my away rotations and just whenever I'm in the hospital, the focus on intentional communication and being an empathetic scholar, I felt all of that was incorporated in the compassionate practice and really set me up to succeed.
Let's go! Let's go!
Thanks for watching Frog Center and Match Day at the Ann Burnett Marion School of Medicine at Texas Christian University.